amateur fighter. I'm going to talk to Brandon Krause. He was an amateur fighter. He trains amateur fighters. So, Brandon, walk us through it. How does someone with zero knowledge, zero experience in boxing, walk into your gym and become an amateur boxer that competes and fights for trophies, belts, medals, and all that?
So, okay, the long and the short I tell people is this. There are three milestones that you need to complete before I feel comfortable going to the amateur fights and letting you represent the gym, right? Because ultimately, you're my product. Like, you know, you're going to show what the worth of my business. So I want to make sure that you actually know how to fight before I get you up there.
And don't forget safety.
And safety, well, of course. I mean, it all goes without saying. First and foremost, you need to get through three rounds of competitive sparring. With somebody your size, your experience, that is also an outlaws fighter. So like in-house sparring, you'd have to be able to get through three competitive rounds with that. Second milestone is you'd have to get through those same three rounds of competitive sparring in my ring with somebody not from my gym. So somebody that you don't know, somebody from another gym, right? And then the third milestone is we need to go to somebody else's gym. You need to spar somebody you don't know in their gym, minimum of three competitive rounds. And once you show me your ability to handle that, then we're good to go. Then I can start showing you like the logistics of,
okay,
of how to specifically get your amateur book, take you to the fights, all, you know, the process of actually.
What does it cost to become an amateur fighter?
I think your USA book's like 60, 70 bucks.
That's it.
And that's it.
And what about tournaments? They only cost 10 bucks.
You have to get a physical too.
Okay, that costs.
And then tournaments, you know, different tournaments cost a few bucks. Nothing too crazy.
How about the gear? If someone comes in here, they need to have their own headgear, their own gloves, their own wraps, their own.
Somebody coming to my gym for the first time, I tell them I have everything. You don't need anything but some clothes to sweat in. Hey, little girl.
You don't need just clothes to sweat in and the towel.
Just some clothes to sweat in, but I also say, putting your hands into sweaty gloves and knowing it's your sweat is very comforting.
Yes, and gloves today are not like the most expensive thing on the planet. There's a lot of companies, a lot of options.
Yeah, 50, you know, 50, 60 bucks, you got your like kind of like entry-level glove.
One time I had a kid who said, Ellie, please, I need a pair of gloves. I love boxing, and all the gloves in my gym smell bad, and please help me. So I had a company here in the Valley step up and donated him a pair of gloves.
Nice.
And they sent it to him, and he got it. And you know what he said when he got it? Why didn't you send me expensive gloves? Why did you send me those? Like, dude,
we can't look the gift horse in the mouth, as they say.
Listen, it cost him nothing. I contacted people we came through for him.
Yeah.
And, you know, use that until, or get a job and save up some money and buy gloves.
Save some money.
But I understand life is tough, so we want to do something
Coach
nice for
I
him.
Coach, I can't afford gym news. Shows up with $500 of winning sparring gear.
It happens?
Yeah, it happens all the time.
So, what's the timeline? Because you said to spar three people. Like, I know you can't pinpoint each person's different, but normally, what does it take? 6 months, like from the moment they walk in here till the moment they fight. About, Brandon, you've dealt with hundreds of people over the years.
Yeah.
What's the average?
And it's all over the place. Average?
Like 9 months, 6 months, normally? More?
I can't even say average, because like even within the population of people that want to compete, even they have different motivations. Some people, it's like going to be their rocky moment. Like they're going to have a fight or two, and then that's going to be their experience with boxing.
And that's all they want.
Yeah, and some people, you know, they're going to be on the circuit and they're going to be fighting all the time, and they're going to try to become Olympians and have hundreds of fights, you know? Some people are using it just to bypass to become professional. Some people,
self-defense, like
it's
the young lady
on their bucket list, you know? So it's all different, man.
Do you want to be a pro fighter?
Amanda.
Do you want to be a pro fighter, Amanda? Or are you just doing it for... Because you competed in MMA before, right?
No, I do boxing and jiu-jitsu.
Okay, but what do you want to compete in if you had a choice?
Well, both. Like, so, okay. Separately. I'm just doing it because I like to do it, and whatever happens, happens.
Have she had fights yet?
No, not yet, but she got her book, and we're going to start competing.
That's awesome. Good luck.
Thank you.
Can you wait for your first time in a fight, or...?
Yeah.
So you've done the three-round sparring here, you sparred other people, and she's done everything you said.
She has met the guidelines, yes.
Okay, so you're ready to fight tonight?
I'm ready.
How will she do?
No. I think she's going to be very successful.
What weight class is she going to be?
150.
150? All right.
The 152.
So you can fight 152 weight class, so you don't have to kill yourself to make weight. Is that better that you walk around in your weight? But you'll fight someone that maybe walks around 160.
In the amateurs, which is most important, is that you have... an abundance of energy. So you shouldn't do anything that's going to sacrifice your energy because it's just three rounds, and for her it's going to be 2 minutes. And
three
and
rounds of 2 minutes? Quickly. Even for women?
For women, 3 2-minute rounds.
And for men?
Starting 3 2-minute rounds and eventually having 3 3-minute rounds when you're in the open division.
Yeah, you know, Sean Porter used to fight in amateurs at 164, 65, yeah?
65, yeah.
And then turned pro at 54 and now fights at 47.
Yeah.
And he fought Usyk in amateurs and actually beat Usyk.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Did you know that? Sean Porter beat Usyk in amateurs?
No.
Huh? Bryce!
I did not know
that. That's crazy. Oh, well, yeah. Good luck.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, guys, there you have it. Turning into an amateur fighter. We're talking here to Brandon Krause. Brandon, who's the best amateur you've ever seen in your life, live?
Best amateur I've ever seen in my life, live?
Yes, at all the tournaments.
Anyone? You know, it's the thing, like Cliff would tell you better, probably, because when I go to the amateur fights with my guys, like, it's just, I'm all about my guys. Like, I'm just, like, focused
out
on them.
Yeah.
I'm just really zoned out. And then when my guy's done fighting, it's like, okay, now I gotta go home and, you know, be a dad and be a husband and run a gym.
So you can't say that you have seen someone in amateurs, you say, wow, this kid will be a pound for pound one day.
I mean, yeah, I've seen those guys.
But they don't come to mind.
Names are not popping into my head right now. My guys, man. My guys. Matthias Radcliffe.
So, one more question on this. When you say that you go to other gyms to spar, back in the day they had what's called smokers, where it would be like a fight with the ref and, yeah. Right? That, when I started covering boxing 11 years ago, it was still part of the culture.
I used to box in smokers when I was young.
I've been to a few of those, but now I don't know how many 5, 6, 7 years ago they eliminated them.
Yeah.
Why?
Yeah. Well, look, if
but that's the way to learn and get experience without having to fight.
No, but bad things can happen, and
like what? Bad things can happen in sparring.
And bad things can happen in competitive sanctioned bouts also, but you need to have that governing body with a set rules that everybody adheres to, and that's what you miss even in a well-ran smoker.
So they don't do smokers anymore. But the smokers that you've been to,
and
they bad?
So, and also, good? Look, so I take fighters to USA Boxing sanctioned events, and I'm a USA Boxing sanctioned coach. If I were to take my fighters to a smoker and one of the governing, one of the referees or officials would hear about it, I would lose my credentials. I could no longer take my fighters to those fights anymore. So it's definitely not worth it to me. Where you brought up, oh, to gain experience. Well, that's what USA Amateur Boxing is for. It's to help you gain experience. And like I said previously, there's more than enough opportunities to fight every single weekend if you just want to schlep far enough and put that much dedication into it.
One thing I like about boxing, well, you don't have this in other sports. I played basketball my whole life. Unless we won the championship, we never got a trophy or a medal. Number two doesn't count, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Well, in boxing, if you don't win, you can still get something. You can get medals. I've seen trophies. I've seen belts.
I've seen it, but I've also seen the loser not get anything.
I've never seen that ever.
And,
I mean, I've seen the losers, at least where I've been always, they always get medals, trophies.
You got up there, you fought. You know, that's what...
You sacrificed this whole time.
Why don't you get a medal for losing in basketball, football, baseball? Because those are games, all right? And that shouldn't happen. But boxing, it's a fight. It's a battle. It's a drama. It's a quest. And you should get some credit just for being up there. You know, that's why a lot of non-boxing heads are confused that in pro boxing, like, the winner doesn't, like, get, like, a special bonus or something like that. And that the loser is paid the same price, either whether or not to lose or not, because you're paid to fight. You're paid to get up there and challenge yourself and compete and to show the fans this drama that they want to see.
What's the toughest part, you as a coach, what's the toughest part to teach people? Is it to keep the hands up? Is it the stance? Is it to teach them to come in on time? Like, what's the toughest part with people in general?
Look, you got to be patient. Like, that's the job I signed up for, so I just got to be very patient. And nothing's tough if they bring to the table the things that are unteachable. If they bring work ethic, if they bring grit, if they bring determination, then I can do my job. In fact, I can't do my job without those things in the first place. So I don't teach things like that. Those are innate to the person. And then with those things, I can start the education process of being proficient up there.
A lot of people watch a movie about a musician and want to play the guitar. Watch Rocky and want to be a boxing champion. How many people walk in this door and say, Brandon, I want to be a professional boxer? Does that happen?
Yes, it happens.
And we know it's not realistic with everybody. Because even with the amateurs that do compete in years, not all of them turn pro. What do you tell? Are you honest with them and you say, listen, guys, I don't know if you could become a pro. Why don't you start first throwing a jab?
Well, here's the thing.
You don't want to crush their dreams either.
I don't want to be a dream crusher, but if you like waltz into my gym because you're in your mid-20s and you've been fired from a couple jobs and you didn't make it through school.
It happens to the best of us.
And you're not meeting your other responsibilities, expectations. But now all of a sudden you're going to come in here and you're gonna excel at the sport that requires the most amount of dedication of any other sport, and that you get the least amount of reward for, at least in the beginning, at least for the vast majority of boxers. You're going to dedicate your whole life to possibly be fighting for $1,000 a round at some point, you know what I mean? So that's a little far-fetched sometimes to hear that from people. But I can't say it's impossible. You know, you could definitely come in here in your mid-20s and make this a career, but you're starting real far behind.
Message to people who are just starting boxing, what would you tell them, and people who are just getting familiar with a gym in the world?
Keep going. Boxing is a beautiful sport. Boxing is where you can really learn a lot about yourself, learn to excel, learn to challenge yourself, and see yourself progress and get better. And what a beautiful thing that is.
There you have it, Brandon Krause. Thank you most for the explanation about amateur boxing. Let's see you guys get into it and how you do in this sport. FaceDudeReporting.com. I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter @Seckbach. You can follow me on Instagram @Elie Seckbach.